Ladies and gentlemen, 2 years ago I said that, introduced myself in Paris by saying that I was the man who had accompanied Mrs. Kennedy to Paris. I'm getting somewhat that same sensation as I travel around Texas.
When the president appeared out in the parking lot, he broke one of the cardinal rules of security. He went out into the crowd, and of course, Secret Service men find this the most nervous time of any presidential appearance. As long as the Secret Service men can keep the crowd away from the president, they have a good chance of protecting him. Here comes the president.
This crowd started gathering out here quite early this morning. I was out here at about 7:45, and already a few diehards have gathered early to ensure a good vantage point. Police were circling the field all morning long from the early morning hours, and a huge contingent of police are on hand. Some brilliant yellow roses, some brilliant red roses have been brought out and will be presented to the First Lady. The President is up to the fence now, shaking hands with people, the President and his wife. This is great for the people and makes the eggshells even thinner for the Secret Service, whose job it is to guard the man.
I'm Zapruder.
Mr. Zapruder?
Zapruder, yes, sir.
Zapruder. And would you tell us your story, please, sir?
I get out and about a half hour earlier and get into a good spot to shoot some pictures.
Billy, tell me what you saw and what you felt. What happened to you?
We just come from Love Field after seeing the president and the first lady, and we were just in front of the triple underpass on Elm Street, and we were at the edge of the curve.
As the president was coming down from Houston Street making his turn, it was about halfway down there, I had a shot.
But the president's car was some 50 feet still yet. And the gunner was coming towards us, and we heard the first shot, and the president, I don't know who was hit first, but the president jumped up in his seat.
Then he slumped to the side like this. Then I heard another shot or two, I couldn't say whether it was one or two.
Head in her arms as the presidential limousine raced to the hospital. She kept crying, oh no.
And just now we've received reports here at Parkland that Governor Connally was shot in the upper left chest. And an unconfirmed report says the president was hit in the head. That's an unconfirmed report that the president was hit in the head.
The president was shot in the head. This is what I've been told now, Jay. The president was shot in the head. Connally was shot in the chest.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. You'll excuse the fact that I'm out of breath, but about 10 or 15 minutes ago, a tragic thing, from all indications at this point, has happened in the city of Dallas. Let me quote to you this, and you'll excuse me if I am out of breath. A bulletin, this is from the United Press from Dallas. President Kennedy and Governor John Connally have been cut down by assassin's bullets in downtown Dallas. They were riding in an open automobile when the shots were fired. The president, his limp body carried in the arms of his wife, Jacqueline, has rushed to Parkland Hospital.
There has been an attempt, as perhaps you know now, on the life of President Kennedy. He was wounded in an automobile driving from Dallas Airport into downtown Dallas, along with Governor Connally of Texas. They've been taken to Parkland Hospital there, where their condition is...
He was, as you probably know by now, shot, along with the governor of Texas, in a motorcade in Dallas, Texas, by unknown assailants so far.
A quote, Clint Hill, a Secret Service agent, this is from the United Press. Clint Hill, a Secret Service agent assigned to Mrs. Kennedy, said he's dead as the president was lifted from the rear of the White House touring car.
From Dallas, Texas, the flash, apparently official, President Kennedy died at 1 p.m. Central Standard Time, 2 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, some 38 minutes ago.
Can you tell me what your first reaction was, ma'am?
We were all crying in my place, all crying.
You look as though you've been crying. Is that how it struck you first?
Yes.
Sir. My first reaction, sir, is that I hope these Southerners, these radicals, have satisfied they got their pound of flesh and killing a man as good as that.
Well, my first reaction was I was terribly shocked. I couldn't believe that it really happened. But I disagree with this man about it being a right-wing radical. It could have been communist, I think, probably something like that.
Sort of fell in on Dallas at this moment. We went in with the Secret Service officers. We covered every inch of the building from the roof to the basement. There was no sign of the man. About six or seven witnesses said that they had seen this man, but of course, at a time like this, everybody sees everybody,
right.
And
right.
It's hard to tell which is true and which is not.
Joe, Jerry Hill with the Dallas Police Department just leaned out a window there, looked to me like he was on the fourth floor, and told police to call the Dallas Crime Laboratory to the scene. Apparently, they found some shells there in that room here in the Texas School Book Depository building, I believe on the fourth floor in the police crime lab, currently en route to the scene as the search continues.
So he would have been directly above us.
Directly above us.
Also in this same area, they found a bag of chicken, they found several bottles of soft drink,
yeah.
And in other words, the man had been planted there for some time.
He could have been there for quite some time.
A Dallas policeman has been shot and killed while chasing the suspected assassin in the West Jefferson area of Dallas.
A witness at the scene of the killing said that the police officer talked briefly with the young man, and the young man then shot the police officer twice through the head.
This is the scene where the police officer was shot. The car that you see in the background there belonged to the police officer, and this woman said that she had seen a man run up, stop the officer, and then shoot him. This gun that you see in the background here in this officer's hand is the one that allegedly was used to shoot the police officer.
Information, Police Captain Pat Ganaway today said a suspect held in the assassination, the picture you just saw here, was an employee of the building where a rifle was found.
Here is a suspect. Will you roll it, please? A suspect is coming.
Turn it on. I'd
like some legal representation. These police officers have not allowed me to have any. I don't know what this is all about.
I killed the president. Black guy.
No, sir, I didn't. People
How'd
keep
you get
asking
the black
me
guy?
That.
Sir?
Did you shoot the president?
I work in that building.
Were you in the building at the time?
Naturally, if I work in that building, yes, sir.
Back up, man.
Did you shoot the president?
No, they're taking me in because of the fact that I live in the Soviet Union.
What time did you leave the building?
I'm just a patsy.
This investigation has been carried on jointly by the FBI, the Secret Service, the Rangers, and the Dallas Police Department. Captain Fritz has been in charge. Charges of murder have been accepted against him.
Are you going to bring him out?
Mr. Wade?
Yes, sir.
Do you expect a confession from this man?
No.
Well, I was questioned by a judge. However, I protested at that time that I was not allowed legal representation. But during that very short and sweet hearing, I really don't know what the situation is about. Nobody has told me anything except that I'm accused of murdering a policeman. I know nothing more than that, and I do request someone to come forward to give me a legal assistance.
Did you kill the president?
No, I've not been charged with that. In fact, nobody has said that to me yet. The first thing I heard about it was when the newspaper reporters in the hall asked me that question.
You have been
fired. Nobody said what?
Sir?
You have been
fired. Nobody said what?
Okay, we can't hear you. Okay.
What did you do in Russia?
Help! A policeman hit me.
Does he appear sane to you?
Yes, he does.
Is he a member of any communist front organization?
Well, the only one I mentioned was the Free Cuba Movement or whatever that...
Fair Play for Cuba,
I believe was that.
Do you have any evidence that anyone is behind him, any organization or group?
No, sir.
How would you describe his mood during the questioning?
Very arrogant. Mm-hmm. Has been all along.
What does he say, Chief?
He just denies everything.
Is there any doubt in your mind, Chief, that Oswald is the man who killed the president?
I think this is the man that killed the president.
Was there any surveillance? Were police aware of his presence in Dallas?
We in the police department here did not know he was in Dallas. I understand the FBI did know that he was in Dallas.
Then if the FBI had known about him ahead of time and had informed your office, you would have checked up on Oswald as well?
I'd rather not speculate on what might have happened if something else had happened. I don't know.
And here the anticipation grows as literally hundreds of police officers have ringed the... Now this is the armored truck that will carry Lee Harold Oswald from the basement here of Dallas Police Headquarters.
Yeah, he's got to be here. There he is.
There he is.
Here he comes.
Now the prisoner will run up.
There is Lee Oswald.
He's been shot. He's been shot. Lee Oswald has been shot. There's a man with a gun. It's absolute panic. Absolute panic here in the basement of Dallas Police Headquarters. Detectives have their guns drawn. Oswald has been shot.
Oswald expired at 1:07 p.m. He died at 1:07 p.m. We have arrested the man. The man will be charged with murder.
Who is he?
The suspect's name is Jack Rubenstein, I believe. He goes by the name of Jack Ruby. That's all I have to say.